It's Water Cooler Wednesday.
Yes, ma'am, it is. Here today, Michelle McKissick, editor of Memphis Parent Magazine, Kevin Cerrito with Cerrito Trivia and Sports 56, and our very own Todd Demers. Guys, welcome.
Thanks.
You're looking great over there.
Glad to be here.
Ready to talk?
I guess so.
All right, let's do it.
We'll find out. Okay, well, the internet is talking, man, flipping out over these photos of the counselor to the president, Kellyanne Conway, with her feet on the couch in the Oval Office. She's now responding to the controversy, saying she, quote, meant no disrespect, end quote, and that she was simply trying to take a photo from a certain angle without getting in the way of reporters. So, you've been one of those reporters that, you know, you don't
I
want
have.
People getting in the way. So what do you think?
And I take a lot of pictures. I've got four kids, so I take a lot of pictures. You know, obviously it's not a problem taking the picture, but I think anytime it, oh gosh, this is a loaded one. But for one thing, if you're going to wear a dress, there's certain demeanor you have to have in a dress. And that was what, you know, just up in that sofa, never mind, you know, shoes up in the sofa, but with the dress and the stance in which she had.
Could have gotten into more trouble, huh?
Yeah. Okay. Hello.
All right, Kevin, how do you see it for the inside the Oval Office? wait a minute. What are you?
Okay.
But he's not wearing a dress.
Thankfully, he's not.
I do not have a problem with this whatsoever. And it's very rare for me to stick up for anybody in the Trump administration, but there's been much worse things that happened in the Oval Office over the years. And definitely much worse things that happened in this administration in the first month. So I don't really blame her for, she came out and apologized, and that's great. Like, it could have been much worse, right? She could have said it was an alternative image or something, and that she really didn't sit on the couch that way. So I'm fine with it.
That is clever, my friend, clever. I don't know how I'm going to be able to top that. I'm ready to give her a pass. I know that she's had a lot of controversy, and there's a lot of folks that probably don't like her and are really upset about disrespecting the office and things like that, but it doesn't sound like there was ill intent here.
Oh,
it just seems like she was trying to stay it up somebody's way. I think it's sad that it happened, because it does, in my opinion, look like it's kind of disrespectful for that highest position in the entire world. But it happened, and I bet you it doesn't happen again.
You know what? But it comes a little bit down to home training. I just don't think.
And don't
you
so many
be
things, right?
Put your feet up in the subway. I mean, you
we
just
gotta
don't
keep
do
it moving here.
Since,
we got a few
when,
other. Got a few other things.
We worry about the first couch. I mean, come
we'll
on.
Get to it. All right, sticking with politics, an Arizona gubernatorial candidate is holding nothing back from voters. Noah Dyer does not just include his political platform on his campaign website, but also what he calls the nitty-gritty details of his personal life, which includes a list of his financial woes and his sexual history. The Democrat, who's also a marketing executive, says voters want an honest politician. So, Kevin, what do you think of his approach?
Well, he's being honest, and I guess he can use his website as both his Tinder profile and his website. Double up for both of them.
Swipe left if you want to vote for me. Swipe right if you don't.
Exactly.
You think he's a millennial with maybe TMI,
yeah.
Like, let's put everything out there?
I think it was definitely TMI, and I understand him trying to be transparent, but from what I just happened to see this, it was just too much. I don't want to know all that. I don't want to know all of that.
Is it possible that he was worried about some of his competitors finding out what would be considered dirt on him, and he's figuring, nope, here's everything, now you can make your own decision, I don't have to worry about somebody saying something bad about me. I agree the two TMI thing. No, that's just too much. I don't need that.
Okay, well, how about Pope Francis? I think we're going to a safer topic.
Talk about a transition.
He recently said it might be better to be an atheist than a greedy Christian. The pontiff made his comments during a sermon Thursday in Rome. Pope Francis said Christians who exploit people and lead a double life scandalize the church. Todd.
Yeah, that's tough talk from the Pope right there. I think, if anything, it's made to get people thinking about their life and how they live their life and whether or not they are exercising their Christian values, because I think sometimes people get caught up in their life. They get moving in one direction and, oh, I'm a Christian. It's like, well, you're not acting like one. And if anything, I think he's just trying to say, you need to examine your life and see whether or not you're following the way you're supposed to be.
Michelle, the words are very bold. What do you think?
What he said.
No.
As a leader of the flock, I understand him sharing his perspective of what he believes Christians should do. You know, so I think if you're a true Christian, you have the love of God in your heart, it will manifest itself.
Mm. Yeah.
Kevin? Well, it's about being a good person, right? It doesn't matter what you label yourself as long as you are a good person. That's what matters, and I think that's what he's trying to say here. You can call yourself whatever you want, but if you don't act like a good person, then you're not going to actually be a true representation of a Christian.
I think it's taking it a little bit too far to say you're either an atheist or you're this. It's like, you know, as you said, you can be a good person and have a full heart, but don't label.
But maybe he had to catch people's attention.
And I think he did just that.
Oh, he sure did.